Hey everybody, thanks for being here. You know, a few years ago, after visiting several other parts of Central America, I visited Panama for the first time, which made a very strong impression on me, and ever since, there's been no doubt in my mind that I would return. Of course, the fishing is amazing, but I also really enjoyed seeing the very cosmopolitan Panama City, one of the fastest growing cities in the world, and by far the most modern city in Central America. It's definitely worth spending a few extra days exploring, which should include seeing the Panama Canal itself and the historic Casco Viejo, or the old city of Panama. Now, to make a long story short, in planning a return trip to Panama and to scout out some fishing opportunities for some friends who also wanted to visit Panama, I asked the advice of the management at the Veneto Hotel in Panama City, who work closely with the best lodges and is typically where most fishermen overnight en route to where they will be fishing. And that's how I ended up here, at the Panama Big Game Fishing Club, that after a recent multi-million dollar remodeling, is now considered by many the new number one fishing lodge in Central America, and among the top 10 in the world. This area is famous for its blue and black marlin, but there's so much more to experience in this remote corner of Panama. Stay tuned, because we're going to experience some of the best fishing our world has to offer, in one of the most beautiful, special places on Earth. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Most mornings, the howler monkeys of Boca Brava Island greet the sunrise as they begin their day in one of the world's most pristine tropical paradises. At roughly 9 miles long and not nearly as wide, Boca Brava is bordered by the Pacific on one side and a saltwater river on the other. And nestled in the treetops is the Panama Big Game Fishing Club. This fishing resort has invested heavily in protecting and enhancing the wildlife found on the island. For example, the above-ground power lines are being relocated underground for the safety of the monkeys, and the key plants and trees that provide food are cared for and protected. The result is a working symbiotic relationship between the wildlife and one of the most incredible fishing lodges in the world. It's not unusual to see the howler monkeys feeding in the canopy above the lodge, and feel the evidence of the abundance of food falling on your head, which really doesn't hurt. The monkeys are by no means tame and are not fed unnaturally by the lodge. They just exist as they should. As do the marlin of the famous Hannibal Bank, which is about an hour and a half run from the lodge. The lodge's manager, Victor Archbold, with an experienced captain and deckhand, are determined to show us exactly what type of fishing can be expected during a stay at the lodge. Today, we're after marlin, most likely black marlin. But first things first, and that means we need bait, with bonito being the best. And when you catch them 8 at a time, getting bait doesn't take long. In this region of Panama, the ocean floor is a tangle of mountainous ravines and steep drop-offs. Perfect habitat for the black marlin, which typically likes to associate with some sort of structure. The Panama Big Game Fishing Club reports catching a ratio of about 60% black marlin to 40% blues. The deckhand, Narciso, is no stranger to these fish, with to date 959 marlin leadered and released. And today, he's looking for number 960. One way to keep your shirt clean while catching bait is to not wear it. But it's probably best to remember to put it on before you hook up with a fish that's well over twice your size.
I think it's going to be a black marlin, about 450 pounds.
Fishing lodge in the world.
Welcome back to Panama. I'm Justin Wolf. The staff at the Panama Big Game Fishing Club is showing us some of the amazing fishing that their guests do on a regular basis. And we've started off by catching and releasing a 400-pound plus black marlin. The recipient of numerous recent awards as the top lodge in Central America, the Panama Big Game Fishing Club is built into a hilltop on Boca Brava Island, where everything about the lodge, boats, and equipment used is very high-end. Getting to the lodge begins with at least one fun-filled night at the Veneto Hotel in Panama City, where in the morning you'll be transported to the close-by regional airport for a short flight to the city of David, where you'll be picked up for the short drive to the Pacific coast through some of the prettiest countryside in Panama. Soon the road ends at the dock in the little town of Boca Chica, where you'll be met by the lodge's transport boat for the short ride across the saltwater river to Boca Brava Island, where new ownership in recent years has invested millions to remodel and to create the perfect fishing lodge. The little blue train is used to transport you and your luggage up the hill to paradise, where you should always keep your eyes open for monkeys. Once at the lodge, every wish is at your disposal, and it's a great place just to relax and watch the jungle. But soon the morning will come, and today we're going to find out just what kind of inshore fishing is available out of the Panama Big Game Fishing Club. This part of Panama is famous for its giant roosterfish, but there's lots of other species out here as well. Today, Narciso plans on using a combination of lures, live bait, and dead bait to target a wide variety of species. Here, the inshore fishing really isn't inshore. Today, it's about an hour's run out to the Cicas Islands, a large area of beautiful little islands with incredible rock structure surrounded by very deep water. Perfect habitat for giant predatory fish.
It's a blue runner for roosterfish, cobra, snapper.
We're fishing in what's considered the off-season, with most anglers choosing to fish during the drier months between December and April. But with a light raincoat, a little rain is really no big deal. I've heard the Cicas Islands described as a Jurassic Park for fish, so I guess it's no surprise to hook up with a dinosaur-sized needlefish.
This is a needlefish, it's more. It's more one.
I think Narciso is joking about that being a small one. But who knows, maybe they do grow even larger in this Jurassic Park.
Yes.
Narciso had put out some trolling flies to catch bonito for bait, but at first there were no bonito, just this beautiful Spanish mackerel.
A Spanish mackerel.
A few minutes later, we had our bonito hooked up and into the tuna tubes, which will be used to hopefully catch larger cobra snapper or roosterfish. We pulled into a good bottom fishing area and dropped down one of the bonito. And you can see what happens when a big Cabrera snapper just misses the hook. And it could have been a giant, as just recently the new world record Cabrera snapper at 89 pounds 12 ounces was caught by an angler fishing out of the Panama Big Game Fishing Club. Trolling another live bonito, Narciso has now hooked up with what he thinks is a big roosterfish. But it has also missed the hook. Roosterfish are in the jack family, so they lack teeth. So instead of being torn to shreds, the bait simply has the telltale rub marks. But it doesn't take long before we're hooked up with that big rooster we're after. Rocky outcroppings of the Cycas Islands provide countless ambush points for roosterfish and all sorts of other predatory fish. And another really fun way to fish this type of structure is with topwater baits. Using an invisiswivel to connect braided line to mono leader, Narciso works a topwater bait among the rocks. He's hoping for another giant roosterfish, which on a topwater plug is one of the ultimate light tackle experiences. But today, another extremely hard-fighting fish took the bait. A big jack crevalle like this is quite an experience to hook and land, and just another example of the incredible fishing found in Panama.
Adios.
We're fishing the Cycas Islands, about an hour offshore from Boca Brava Island, home of the Panama Big Game Fishing Club. So far on this trip, we've hooked black marlin, a giant needlefish, a great-eating Spanish mackerel, a big rooster, and a jack crevalle on a topwater plug. At Panama Big Game Fishing Club, they say if you didn't get what you wanted, you didn't ask. Well, I want wahoo for dinner. The wahoo is one of the best-eating fish in the ocean, so with that nice big one on ice, it's time to head back to the lodge to let Chef Patrick Quere work his magic.
Well, today we're going to do a nice sautéed filet wahoo. That fish that you see here was swimming about an hour ago right off the coast right here. We're going to do sautéed wahoo with a lemon, actually a lime, butter sauce with a little bit of white wine. You dip your wahoo here in a little bit of milk, and then you with a little bit of seasoned flour. Very simple. And then you saute your fish in a saute pan with a little bit of olive oil, a little bit of butter. Delicious. There we go. Right here. And now you wait till your fish is nice and golden brown on one side. As you can see, look how quick that is. Nice color. Okay. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna put it in the oven, I would say for about between 5 and 7 minutes. The oven is about 375. There we go. In general, most people, what they do, they grill the fish or they broil it. What I did, I just sauteed in a saute pan and sear it so it keeps all the juice inside the fish. And then we're gonna deglaze the fish with a little bit of white wine and butter and lime and parsley, and that's a done deal.
It's a done deal, all right, and that was the best Wahoo I've ever eaten. The next morning, we're on the water to experience another type of fishing out of the Panama Big Game Fishing Club. The Saltwater River and surrounding area is a pristine mixed mangrove environment with many opportunities for light tackle fishing.
All right, so now we're looking for sardines. It's quite a difficult in the morning, but we will see them. As you can see, there's not, the way you find it, you see in the surface, if you see any jumping, any little fish jumping, that's sardines. That's what you get with the casting nets, and then you get the sardines. But now, you know, just waiting for, so get some bait.
Today, we'll be live bait fishing for mangrove snapper, but the use of artificials is certainly possible as well. When looking for bait fish, diving birds are always a good sign.
This is a good catch. Got our first live sardine now. Those are smaller sardines. They're good for snapper as well. We have about 3 different kinds of sardines here, so, but they're all good for it.
Linda!
Oh, that's the one we were looking for. We just found the right size and the right sardine for mangrove snapper fishing.
Now it's just a matter of finding where the snapper will be feeding. We've pulled into a spot where we can anchor at the top of a drop-off, where the moving tide should stimulate some feeding action.
There he is. Es un mango snapper.
Qué verga es.
This is a fun, relaxing type of fishing, which guests might enjoy as a break between days out on the big water. Plus, you end up with some excellent fish for eating. Welcome back to the northwest corner of Panama. I'm Justin Wolf. We're fishing the inshore mangroves for mangrove snapper, which are just like their cousins that live out in the big water, but just not as big, but just as good eating.
Yeah, they're really good eating. It's a great fish to eat. So this is, could be our dinner.
That's a little wild.
Besides snapper, there are snook in these waters, as well as the smaller cousins of the snook.
This is what we call a little snook. It's not really snook, but it's we call it snook because snook is exactly the same. It's just that this figure doesn't grow bigger than that. That's all.
Moving around from hole to hole gives you a chance to see this beautiful mixed mangrove region of Panama, which makes for a relaxing day. But when you find feeding fish, things can get busy.
Compromise.
el guante que tiene 40 libras. ¿Qué tú pensas? Estúpida.
This snapper is a little on the small side, so it will be released for another day. This one's a little more like it, the kind of fish that you'd want to take back to Chef Patrick. And any of these fish, you're welcome to take back to the Veneto Hotel on your way home, where you can have it prepared in the New York Steakhouse by the renowned executive chef, Pedro Masilaver, one of the most well-known and respected chefs in this part of the world. If you'd like to see the complete instructional video on how he prepared this Spanish ceviche, just go to AnglerWestTV.com.
I hope I see you in Panama soon. Bye.
And while at the Veneto, you have to experience the great rooftop pool and hot tub, as well as the full-service Veneto Spa, with a jacuzzi, sauna, steam room, and incredible massages by the Veneto's professional masseuse. And at night, you can just relax or head down to the casino to experience the nightlife that Panama is somewhat famous for. And if you want to experience the best that Central America has to offer, then consider a trip to the Panama Big Game Fishing Club. To call it a world-class experience is an understatement. You can find out all the details by visiting the lodge's website at panama-sportfishing.com. Or call their U.S. number at 786-600-1672. Okay, thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that this show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.